Paul O'Brien, thanks for joining us. Let's talk about last night's result. 40 points doesn't look good. The girls just couldn't get it going.
No, look, from the start of the game last night, we probably had to have a lot of things go right. When you're playing against a quality team like Dandenong, who from the coaching staff right through to the playing group is deserving of their two titles and now obviously their opportunity to defend it and go for a third in a row, which is a great achievement in this league, you have to have everything go right. For us in the first quarter, a couple of things really hurt us. One was our shooting percentage. We weren't able to put scoreboard pressure on early on. I think we went something like 19% in the first quarter to 35%. I think we were 0 for 3 from the 3-point line and we missed a couple of free throws. So where we had the opportunity to put scoreboard pressure on it and maybe trail by say 4 points, we were down by 12 points. And from then on, it was going to be an uphill battle because once Dandenong get their confidence up and the confidence in the fact that, yep, you're the next shooter, take the shot, they're a very tough side to stop.
Paul, I want to talk about your year. A good chance to reflect. I think there's so many things to be positive about. You're almost unbeatable at home for the first part of the year. You had some fantastic development in your players. You had good imports and restricted players. What was the most pleasing aspect this year for you?
Well, look, I think the first thing you've got to talk about is last night's result briefly, and that's to say that you can get caught up with the moment and you can get caught up with the whole idea of what a disappointing result to end the season, and then it dominate your thinking about the rest of the year. Now, from our point of view, we dealt with that last night, and very early on in our discussions, we were already starting to think about 2013, how far we've come this year, what we've learnt, and what we need to do as a group to get back to that game next year, be it against Dandenong or be it against anyone else, be it away or at home, the conference title game next year, what have we got to do? And that's what we spent our time on. And the number one thing we've recognised is that we need to expand and spread the scoring lane. And that the only way you can do that is to continue to work hard with your players in the development of their skill sets. We've got a very young group on our bench. You know, we had basically last night players between the ages of 16 and 25, but in terms of SEABL experience, still a very young group on the bench. Now, that's not taking anything away from the quality of our opponent, but the reality of it is many of the bench players at Dandenong have been in that role or indeed in more senior teams at WNBL level for a number of years. So experience takes time, and we've got to recognise that. So, you know, we've got to look at the way in which we're going to develop our group going forward. But the number one thing we've recognised is to build the capacity of our playing group.
Paul, I want to touch on your culture and also your supporters. I mean, the numbers there last night at your game were fantastic, and it seems like the girls really bought into your program. It's just a good organisational round down there, Paul.
Well, look, I think the thing that really helps us, Ed, is we've got a very good administration, and we're in a transition period in our administration at present because we're moving towards the Geelong Community Basketball Association, which will merge the former Basketball Geelong and Supercats organisations. That's taking time, as you do when you're merging such big and important entities, but we can now see the outcomes clearly in the future. And I think 2013, when virtually all the committees are finalised and the personnel are finalised and those sorts of things have happened, is going to be really exciting for basketball in Geelong. What excited us last night, just before we started, was the fact that we looked around last night and probably at least 50% of the crowd, and I would think possibly more of the crowd, were our supporters. And I made the comment after the game at the post-match that our supporters are rusted on. You know, they love the group, they love the men's team with very, very good reason. They've come to adopt us as well over the last 2 years, and I think they now see it as though we are two very, very strong teams which represent their cities. Geelong has a great sports culture, and it's proud of its teams that do well, and it's proud of its teams that compete and play a style of sport that they enjoy watching.
Well, you do play an exciting brand of basketball, mate. It's good to watch you, and you've come along leaps and bounds in only two short seasons. Sure enough, if you continue that development, you're bound to go much further into the playoffs. Unlucky last night, but congratulations on a great, fantastic year, and thanks for your time today.
All right, thanks, Ed. Appreciate it.